Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Today, we need to talk a little bit about Montrezl Harrell. See, when Anthony Davis and LeBron James went down due to injury, there were a lot of questions flying around. Who's it going to be to really step up for the Lakers? Is it going to be Dennis Schroeder? Maybe it's going to be Kyle Kuzma. And those guys, don't get me wrong, they've had their moments, but consistently night in and night out, the guy to power the Lakers, the guy to step up and fill the void to the best of his ability has been Montrezl Harrell. He's been incredible. And when I dug into the stats, I was shocked by what I saw. I'm Trevor Lane for LakersNation.com. Subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Ring that notification bell right over there. Get notified every time we have a new video coming out. All right, so Trez coming over from the Clippers this last offseason. Look, he crossed hallways, came into the light, joined the purple and gold, left the dark side, and he had a reputation as being a hustle player, and he certainly is that. Don't get me wrong here. He is absolutely a guy who hustles on every single possession. In fact, he is second in the NBA right now in charges drawn, which helps to mitigate the fact that he's 6'7", and that prevents him from blocking shots at the rim sometimes, but he's so good at drawing charges that that's his own version of rim protection. Again, second in the NBA. Kyle Lowry is actually first in the NBA. Imagine if the Lakers had gone ahead with that Kyle Lowry trade. They would have the top two guys at drawing charges at the rim in the NBA. But Trez certainly gets the job done there on that end. And then he's seventh in the NBA in box outs, despite playing just under 25 minutes per game. He is boxing out everybody in sight, fundamentally sound in there. Again, this is how he makes up for the fact that he's 6'7", in addition to the fact that he's got a really long wingspan. That certainly helps as well. But in terms of replacing LeBron James and Anthony Davis, you're not going to do that. Nobody is replacing those two guys. But we looked at him, we said, who's going to step up? Who's going to be the guy that's going to really help keep the Lakers afloat? And check out these stats from Trez because they are ridiculous. With Anthony Davis playing this season, Montrezl Harrell is putting up 13.2 points, 6.3 rebounds, 2.3 of those are offensive boards, and shooting 64% from the field in just under 25 minutes per game. Pretty good. Pretty good stats. No question there. Pretty good. But listen to since AD went down. Go back to February 14th, Valentine's Day. Anthony Davis goes down. We have not seen him on the floor since. Hopefully he's returning soon, but this is what Trez has done in that time period. 16.5 points, 7.2 rebounds, 2.9 offensive rebounds, 62% from the field. Now, here's what's crazy about this. He's playing roughly the same amount of minutes as he was before AD went down, and yet his production has gone way up. And normally, what happens when a star goes down and another player steps in to fill that role? They suddenly get more responsibility. They're getting more shot attempts. They're asked to do more on both ends of the floor. Usually their efficiency goes way down. You'll see their field goal percentage will drop even as their points, rebounds, and things like that go up. Not so much for Montrezl Harrell. Yes, he's taken on a larger responsibility in the offense. The Lakers are looking to him more and more to score the ball, but his field goal percentage has dropped by 2%. That's just about nothing. Dropped from 64% to 62%, which is actually still higher than what he was putting up last season with the Clippers, when every single possession he was running pick and roll and getting runs right at the rim. So somehow, since he became a Laker, he's become an even more efficient finisher at the basket, even though defenses can key on him now more than ever before. So that in and of itself is incredible. That number one, Montrezl Harrell has been able to step up and really pick up his game while the stars have been out. And number two, that he's maintained that kind of efficiency. That is so, so impressive. And then when you dig into the advanced numbers and you look at what happens to the Lakers when Montrezl Harrell is off the floor, oh my goodness, that is when you can really see his value. Check this out. Montrezl Harrell, the team's defense, where he has been criticized the most. Most people who look at Montrezl Harrell say he can't get it done on the defensive end of the floor because of his size. The numbers don't suggest that. Defensively, the Lakers, since losing Anthony Davis on February 14th, with Montrezl Harrell on the floor, put up a defensive rating of 101.6. When Trez is off the floor, that number goes up to 104.2. That means they give up almost 3 points per 100 possessions more when Trez is off the floor than on. He helps their defense, and then the offensive numbers are even greater. With Trez on the floor, the Lakers have an offensive rating of 107.3, and when he's off the floor, they have a rating of 101.3. 5.9. Yeah, 5+ points per 100 possessions worse when Montrezl Harrell is off the floor. And if you're doing the math, you know where this is heading to. That means that the Lakers have a net negative rating when Montrezl Harrell is off the floor. One of the very few players on the team that can say that. The bottom line, when Trez is off the floor, the Lakers are not winning right now. Now, that might change with Andre Drummond coming into the fold. Maybe he's able to turn that and go the other way, but Dennis Schroeder can't say that. Kyle Kuzma can't say that. No, but Montrezl Harrell can. If he is off the floor, the Lakers are losing games. And let's not forget, he's a fantastic teammate as well, stepping up for Dennis Schroeder when OG Anunoby slammed him to the ground in that game against the Toronto Raptors. And he even got fined for it. Didn't seem to bother Trez. He knew he was doing the right thing, stepping up for his teammate, and asked after the game if he had any issues with Anunoby. He gave the quote of the year when he said, "My beef is with anybody who doesn't have a Lakers jersey." Gotta love that. And we know part of the reason why the Lakers were able to get him for that mid-level exception deal was because he struggled so badly in the playoffs last year. So you better believe that he is on pace to right that wrong this offseason. Now, that also begs the question, can the Lakers keep Montrezl Harrell? He's on a 2-year deal, but that second year is a player option, would only pay him a little over $10 million. Now, the Lakers could, if he opts out, they could offer him a new deal, and he is expected to opt out. They could offer him a new deal that would start just over $11 million. Will that be enough to keep Trez around? Fingers crossed. I sure would love to see it, because he has been tremendous for the Lakers, and I think isn't getting quite enough credit for the work that he has done since Anthony Davis went down. But let me know your thoughts on Montrezl Harrell in the comments down below. If you guys want to follow me on social media, you can find me at Trevor_Lane on Twitter, at Trevor Lane NBA on Instagram and Facebook. Till next time, stay safe and see ya.